Web soil survey is available through the South Dakota USDA NRCS website and is a tool that can be used to map and evaluate the soils on your operation. By simply selecting the Start Web Soil Survey button from our webpage, you can access Web Soil Survey. The first thing that a user needs to do is to determine their area of interest. This can be either done by navigating through aerial imagery of the county or selecting your section, township, and range. Once you have the location where the area of interest is located, you can zoom in or out using the zoom buttons on the toolbar. So by zooming into that area, the user can use the area of interest button to draw a polygon over the area where the soils are of interest. And just by drawing and clicking, a polygon can be created. Once the area of interest of polygon is created, by clicking the Soils Map tab at the top of the page, a soils map is generated. And the map unit symbol for each of the soils is then placed over the area of interest, along with the soil map unit boundaries. Now that I've created my area of interest within Web Soil Survey and have created my soils map, I can utilize the Soil Data Explorer tab to look at soil properties and qualities ranging from the chemical properties or the water features of those soils that exist within my area of interest, and a variety of information associated with the suitabilities and limitations of those soils. Everything from building site development to land management, the productivity of those soils for both cropland, grazing land, and water management or other land classifications. There's a variety of ratings that are included within Web Soil Survey, and the best way to discover what's in there is just to utilize the program and explore it. Within the vegetative productivity, suitability, and limitation rating, we can view the ratings for those soils within our area of interest. Those ratings include the pounds per acre per year for each of those map unit symbols. These can be used to develop a grazing management plan and can also be used as a basis to interpret what production might be on those sites. And in situations where we have high production or good moisture situations, along with potentially high sweet clover production, we can look at what sort of extra productivity we might expect that year. Using the Ecological Site Assessment tab, an ecological site map can be made, and also an evaluation of each of the primary ecological sites within the area of interest. By selecting your representative plant community on those soils, we can view plant community information and the expected productivity based on a normal year, an above average year, or a below average year. In this example, for a western wheatgrass green needlegrass plant community on a clay ecological site, we can expect average productivity of around 1,800 pounds per acre. By clicking the Shopping Cart tab and checkout, a custom soil resource report is generated. The custom soil resource report includes a soil map for the area of interest, as well as a legend and the number of acres in the area of interest, along with the number of acres and percent of each soil map unit. The custom soils report provides a brief description for each of the individual soil components that exist within the soil map units within the area of interest. There's a lot of information to explore within Web Soil Survey. So if you need help or assistance, please contact your local USDA NRCS Service Center.